Well, my art installation is a sort of personal desire that I had to acknowledge a school that no longer exists, but that I knew about when I first moved to Dallas. Bishop College was a really exciting place at one time. By the time I moved here in 1980, it was on the decline. And so a lot of people were not really acknowledging what this school had done for the city of Dallas. Even though it's Paul Quinn College now, these students ought to know what kind of ground they walk on. They need to know that this was here and that it's a great legacy to follow. So it was important for me to do something that would bring sort of dignity back to the name of Bishop College. And I'd known about some of the things that happened here, but I had no idea how much happened here. I had no idea how important this institution had been to this community either. I interviewed alums who had been involved in the arts here on the campus. I interviewed Harry Robinson and Ann Williams. Ann Williams, of course, founded the Dallas Black Dance Theater, and it was founded here on this campus. And then Harry Robinson founded what is now known as the African American Museum. And so that's when I really got a sense of how critical this institution had been to the development of black arts in Dallas. We had people like Alex Haley, as he was writing Roots, Maya Angelou, she had just published I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings, Nina Simone, Elia Pomare, Alvin Ailey, Arthur Mitchell. I mean, all of these people were on this campus. And so I started looking at who on the campus were the key players in creating this whole cultural atmosphere. And I created these collages that are basically an homage to each one of them. What I'm hoping people take away from my installation is the idea that history is important, and we can't allow ourselves to forget a piece of history. Bishop College had a very rich, rich legacy that they left this city with. And the black arts in this city would not have developed the way they did without the legacy of Bishop College.